In this tutorial, we will cover using WinToFlash to create a bootable USB drive with Windows XP, Vista, or 7 on it. With the low cost of flash memory taking over the computer industry, optical media drives like CD and DVD drives are going the way of the floppy disk. CD and DVD drives use much-needed battery life in laptops and take up valuable space in the case. Many modern computers, and pretty much every notebook, don't come with a CD or DVD drive, so your only option is to install from a USB drive. Let's download and install WinToFlash. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. In the address bar, enter win2flash.com and press enter. Click the American flag for English. On the WinToFlash homepage, click the download link. Click the link to download the latest version. When asked what you want to do with the file, click the Save As button. On the Save As window that opens, select the desktop, and then click the Save button. WinToFlash does not contain an installer. The download is just the zip file containing all of the files. We'll create a new folder in the Program Files folder, and then create a desktop shortcut for it. When the download finishes, you will see the NovaCore WinToFlash zip file on the desktop. Double-click to open it. Click the Extract All Files button. On the Select the Destination and Extract Files screen, click the Browse button. Expand Computer. Local Disk C. And then click the Program Files folder. Click the Make New Folder button. Name the new folder Win2Flash. And then click the OK button. This will extract the files to C, Program Files, WinToFlash. Click the Extract button. The files will be extracted to the new folder located at C, Program Files, WinToFlash. When the extraction finishes, it will open this new folder with the files in it. Let's create a desktop shortcut, so we don't have to open this folder every time we want to run WinToFlash. Right-click on the WinToFlash.exe file, and select Create Shortcut. It will then create a new shortcut named WinToFlash.exe-shortcut. Let's rename this. Right-click, select Rename, enter the new name of WinToFlash, and press Enter. Now let's move it to the desktop. Right-click and select Cut. Right-click on the desktop somewhere without an icon, and select Paste. We now have a WinToFlash shortcut on the desktop. You can open the application at any time now just by double-clicking on this file. We can close the folder that contained the files. We now need to find out what drive is the USB drive, and which one has our Windows media in it. Make sure you have your Windows DVD in the drive, or your ISO image mounted. Click the Windows Start button, then Computer. The Windows DVD is the E drive. The USB drive is removable disk G. There are already files on the USB drive. You can either format the disk yourself if you like, or just let WinToFlash format the drive automatically. Let's open WinToFlash and create a bootable Windows USB drive. You can create a Windows XP, Vista, or 7 USB installer drive. For this tutorial, we are creating a Windows 7 Ultimate USB drive. Double-click on the WinToFlash shortcut we created on the desktop. On the Open File Security Warning window, deselect, always ask before opening this file, and click the Run button. On the first Start wizard, click the Next button. on the end user license agreement. Click to select I accept EULA. Read the license agreement if you like. And then click the next button. On the key file screen, click the next button. On the commercial screen, click the next button. On the finished screen, click the next button. On the WinToFlash application window, click the Windows Setup Transfer Wizard button. On the WinToFlash wizard, click the next button. Click the Select button for the Windows file path. On the Browse for Folder window that opens, expand Computer, and then select CD Drive E. And then click the OK button. Click the Select button for the USB drive, expand Computer, and then select Removable Disk G. Click the OK button. Now click the Next button. On the Windows License Agreement window that opens, click the Radio button to accept I do accept the terms of the license agreement, and then click the Continue button. If there are files on the drive, you'd receive a format warning asking you if you were sure you wanted to remove all the information on the disk. Ensure that you didn't need the files and then click Continue. You will see the Transferring Windows Setup screen as WinToFlash sets up the USB drive to install Windows 7. The setup time will vary depending on your hardware, but should be less than 20 minutes for Windows 7 and much shorter for Windows XP. When setup finishes, click the Next button. On the Done screen, click the Exit button. On the Free License Note window, click the Next Time button. Okay, so we now have our USB installer with all of our setup files. Now you just need to put this USB drive in the back of your computer, enter the BIOS, and set the boot order so that it boots to the USB drive before it boots to the CD drive or hard drive. And then you install Windows just as you normally would. You should now have the necessary knowledge to download and install WinToFlash and create a bootable USB drive with Windows on it.